Hi there. I'm Rich. At least my name is Rich. WB5YBZ. Today I'm going to talk about how to install or update your firmware in your Kenwood TS2000. All you need is an RS232C, which is a computer cable that goes to your transceiver, your Kenwood TS2000. You need an internet connection, and you need a computer. Of that, it's pretty easy. I'll show you the web pages, where to go. I also will show you where the little switch is on the transceiver and some of the tips. Thanks for watching. You will want to go to this website. It's either copy this down or go to Google and type in Kenwood TS2000 firmware, and you should find it there also. Also, you can go to kenwood.com and find the site also for this. When you get to the website, you can see a list of different ones, like the transceivers, like the 940, and you just scroll on down until you see the Kenwood TS2000. There you will see firmware update program. When you click on how to check the firmware, this will show you how. It'll go to the next page and show you exactly how. Now here's how I did it. So what it says to do is you push your power button, your noise reduction button, and your mic button, all three at the same time. So if I push this one, and then the power, and when you push all that, then you come up with your number of your checksum. Mine's old, it appears. It looks like 8BC9. On the page also, after you've checked your checksum, you can click to see the firmware revision history and see where yours is. For example, mine's the revision 12. I need to update. After you've done that, you would like to go back to your firmware update information and scroll down until you see the information about click here to read or click to read the firmware updating procedure. Then after you read that, click back to this page again and go down to the bottom where it says the 110 zip download. That's where you want to go. Get a screen and just hit open, and that'll start the program. After it opens, you'll have a screen that sort of pops up that looks like this. And you want to hit the setup application. It's sort of highlighted there in blue, but hit setup application. After you've started your program, you just keep on hitting next and next and next. And if you notice, it says really basically turn off all your Windows programs while you're installing this, and then hit finish. Now, the program went into the program files. I have two program files folders. I use a x86, and that's where I found the Kenwood. When you click on that, then you will see your Kenwood. Click on the Kenwood icon, and it'll take you to the TS2000 update. Then you click on the 2000 update, and then the TS2000 version 110. You click on that. Look at this program will come up. Just hit OK, and it should just go on, and it shall say, switch off the TS2000, connect the 2000 to the PC using it, RS232, switch on the TS2000 power. Click OK to continue. And it'd be showing you the rest of the way that I did it. It's basically the same as what it says to do. Just make sure you have the power off the transceiver at the end and the power on the power supply after you turn it on, after you turn on S1. The TS2000 will be off, the power supply will be on. When you take all your screws out, then you just use this as a handle. Just pick it up. And you're going to be looking for the switch for S1. Now, it's sort of hidden down here. But see this little thing right here? That's S1. And very gently, because you can break the little tip off, just sort of click it toward the face of the, or the front of your system.
Make sure your power is off. Then you hook up your .232 and you plug your power in.
Well, you start your program and it'll go through a series of little lines and everything, but one of the things it says, do not operate keyboard and mouse while updating the firmware. So that's something you might want to notice. And of course your other Windows programs are off, like checking email automatically and stuff like that. Once it's completed, it'll say, complete, the firmware has been updated. Then it wants you to unplug all the cables, turn off the switch, and reattach the cables again.
Firmware. So the firmware has been completed. It says to remove the 232. And then it also says to take off the power supply. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. There we go. Now gently come back over here. Do you remember where the switch was? It's hiding. And gently push it away from the front of the radio, or the face of the radio, and turn it back off. That's all it is. If you push it too hard, it'll break off. Now you just put the top, or the bottom, attach the bottom with the screws. All right, you've got your case back on. Now you need to plug in your power again. Remember, it only goes one way. And if you use your 232, you can plug that back in too. Now, in order to, you have to have a full reset. In a full reset, you have to hit the A equal B, which is right here, plus, as you're holding that in, then you hit your power button. It says full reset. And it says push A equals B. So I push A equal B again. And there it is. All your memories are gone. All your memories are gone, and it's back the way it is, but you have your firmware updated. And that's as easy as a pie. Thanks for watching.